The judge panelist chairman, namely as Ahmad Satibi, found Doni Salmanan was not guilty over money laundering charge. He explained that Doni's assets, including cash, house certificates, and sport cars that were confiscated earlier, were not from a criminal act.
Ini.
Oh, ini. And to know more about this situation and comparison between cases, we have now a banking, corporate finance, and security law specialist with us here on the studio, Frank Hutapea. Frank, thank you very much for coming here on our studio. So our first question, how do you see law enforcement in the case of Doni Salmanan? Relating to the robot trading, of course.
Okay, so the noise that was created by the public in the all the publication of the news of the Doni Salmanan case speaks volume about what's wrong about the award.
Yeah.
As a background, we have to explain that Doni Salmanan and the other defendant in a separate case, Indra Kents, they are totally two same case. The problem is, both of them have a problem.
Yeah.
In the first case, Indra Kents, he was sentenced to jail, not for distributing the content of gambling, according to the Indonesian IT law. But he was sentenced to distributing wrong content or a deceivement as if he was publicating content of trading, but in fact it's a gambling. But the problem is, the problem in the Indra Kents award was that all the assets that was created from the crime victims, that was committed, from the victim, was seized by the country, by the state. The problem is, the judge ruled that you cannot be given or return the award if you are gambling. But the problem is, Indra Kents and Doni Salmanan were never indicted for gambling.
From the result of the court, yeah? From the judge?
From the judge. And they were never prosecuted as well for gambling. So, I think the case speaks volume about law enforcement in the investment world in Indonesia. And if I was an investor from outside Indonesia and I see this, I would assume that if you cannot deliver justice to your local, then how on earth are you gonna give security to the foreign investors?
Right. So
that's the key point.
It will come with the bigger issue, yeah.
It parts of the bigger issue.
Mm-hmm.
But the problem is this. Although the public are split between the opinion whether or not the victims are entitled for the return. Because some of the publics, if you see in the internet, they were speaking about, yeah, but when you're investing on something, you know what you're dealing with.
Mm-hmm.
You knew what you were dealing with.
Yes.
And if you're gambling, you knew that you're going to lose something.
Right. So talking about the machine or the tools or the platform that Doni Salmanan and also Indra Kents used, they use robot trading and binary option that actually it's just a like we can say, can we say it's a cover of the gambling?
Okay.
So what's your take from the law perspective of this?
The biggest problem of the court award says that Doni Salmanan is not guilty of the binary trading because, in the words of the judge, because the regulation is not clear yet whether binary trading is regulated or not. But even months ago, the Ministry of Trade and the Bappebti, the commodities trading regulator, explicitly mentioned the list of investment that is blocked or like basically prohibited by the state.
Mm-hmm.
One being the Indra Kents product and the other being Doni Salmanan's product, the one that they were delivering in their media. So how can the judge say that the regulation is not clear when the state, through the Bappebti, through the Ministry of Trade, explicitly say that this is illegal?
Right, so you've mentioned about regulation, so actually let's jump into the topic. What regulation then should be able to regulate this trade so that investors are not trapped in fraud?
Okay, the biggest problem is not in the regulation. Because you can talk about stocks. There's nothing to do with binary trading or Donny Salmon. Stocks is regulated. But if there is a crime happening during the trading of the stocks, then the police can investigate it. So it's not whether it's regulated or not, but whether the legal enforcement can find any wrongdoing. So you can regulate everything, but if there is a wrongdoing, then the regulation will never do anything. Mm-hmm. Because you have to find foul play between the trading. So what's clear here? So I think what the judgment failed to deliver is, it's not whether the players are trading. Obviously, it is already a public knowledge that they were fouled. They were lied on. They were told that this is trading, but in fact it's not. Yeah. So how can you say there is no regulation in binary trading when it is a legal fact that they were not even trading? Right. They were being fouled at.
So you're saying
they were being lied on.
So you're saying that the issue is not on the regulation side, but on the side of law enforcement.
The side of law enforcement. And the award of the Indra Kents and Donny Salmon.
Donny Salmanan
creates a public misconception. Because now the public are thinking that if I was a victim of a foul trading or a scam, I will not file a police report. Not in the mistake of the police, but the award will not be fair to the victim.
Right.
Speaking on my experience as a business lawyer, and this is nothing compared to like what's going on in the business world right now.
Nothing. I mean, it's bigger or
there are a lot of wrong awards in the business world.
Right. So
there are a lot.
Can we say that according to this decision from the judges, it can trigger that? There will be more like Donny Salmon or Indra Kents, because the law enforcement just kind of like this. I mean, you can get the punishment because of the you made the content of the video, for example, and you got the articles from the ITE regulation, but you don't have any obligations to return the money that the victim sends.
I think because the legal enforcement failed to do something earlier, so more and more victims were part of the bigger problems. Because why? Because the public has the misconception like this: if they are at fault, something must have been done already.
Yeah.
The problem is they are still free to buy Lamborghini. They are still free to give 1 billion rupee endorsement to like famous celebrities.
They still can do any flexing activities.
They
on
can
the
do
internet.
Flexing, mm-hmm. And they still can go to Turkey to get a new treatment for the face. So, obviously. They must be doing something right, because if they are wrong, they are in jail already.
Yeah.
So, I think if you see, if we are talking about investment, and there is no way, the public will have trust in the judiciary system, mm-hmm. if even under small matters for Donny Salmon and like Donny Salmon. They fail to deliver justice to the public.
Yeah.
So
that's a key word. Fail to deliver justice to the public. So you've mentioned about the case of Indra Kents and Donny Salmanan. So can you actually share with us how are cases like this compared to the previous cases? Maybe you have.
Yeah. Okay.
The kind of this time.
There are two type of foul trading, mm-hmm. which is a scam. That is going on in Indonesia right now. One is the supposedly binary trading, Donny Salmon and Indra Kents. The other one is robot trading. Indra Kents and Donny Salmon, there are two similar case, but the way totally different court award.
Okay.
But the other one, robot trading, based on what I understood, there are three case, robot trading, totally the same case, mm-hmm. but three different award.
Right, we have this.
Yeah.
Or a big plasma.
Yeah.
Comparison.
So Fakaris, Indra Kents, Donny Salmon, they are 100% of the same case. Mm-hmm. So if you see here, Fakaris is returned to the victim, mm-hmm. the asset, and then for Indra Kents, it's being seized by the state.
Being seized by the state.
Being seized by the state.
But it is not returned to the victims.
Donny Salmon is returned to the defendant.
It's getting more weird.
Even worse.
So what should we do then? What is your advice for law enforcers then?
I think
to see this case. I mean, people like us, the victims, totally need the law enforcers or the lawyers for.
I think
fighting for their right.
I think if you see now the trend in the public, speaking out becoming useless, and I think for the government needs to do some kind of I don't know. They need to have some kind of self. What do you call it? They need to see. They need to look at themselves in the mirror. What am I doing with my life? You know.
From the government side.
From the judiciary system.
Judicial system, not the government.
Yeah,
side.
No.
How about the law related to this from the government side? Is it sufficient for right now, or the government need to like repair the regulation as well?
The problem is that if there is no court word being examined by the top management in the Supreme Court, then they will feel that on everyday basis, on a day-to-day basis, they are free to give an award whatever they feel like giving. Mm-hmm. So I think now is the critical moment in Indonesia where the Supreme Court needs to do some kind of a court word examination. From whatever case.
Okay.
They can start from this case. They need to look at the court word. This is totally wrong. The problem in Indonesia, you only have the top management, the top Supreme Court, they are not allowed to do that.
Right.
They are not allowed to do that. The only thing they can do is to receive a proposal from the KAYE, Commission Judicial.
Mm-hmm. Judicial Commission?
Judicial Commission. The Judicial Commission, they need to do some kind of recommendation to the Supreme Court, right, that this court award is wrong. And in the Supreme Court, they are in the full discretion whether to follow or to reject the recommendation.
Right.
So something must be done to the...
And this is a crucial time, yeah, for at least...
Now is the critical time.
Critical time, starting because from the Judicial Commission for making a recommendation related to this issue at least, and then propose it to the Supreme Court for this.
They need to do something because the foreign investor will feel that if you cannot even defend your own people, then what's going to happen to my investment?
Right. The bigger issue, yeah?
And Indonesia right now, they are focusing on foreign investment. I think that's the whole reason why we had G20, because we need to show to the bigger world that we are capable of like keeping your investment, we're capable of defending your investment, like we are capable of growing your investment.
Yeah. It is a safe thing to invest here.
Safety to invest here.
Right.
And the fact that we managed to hold inflation not as worse as other countries then. But I think right now what's happening with our countries, we're going backwards.
All right, so we will wait for the next step. Hopefully that Judicial Commission will make some recommendation related to this issue, and Supreme Court will eagerly to proceed the issue,
right? Yeah, I think the Supreme Court needs to start examining court word that is being criticized by the public. Mm-hmm. Or otherwise we will be too late then, and the victims of a foul scam, they will start taking matters on their own hands.
And you'll be the one of who will propose, I mean, criticize this issue, right?
I mean, we've been doing it for the past years.
Okay, thank you very much,
Pramu
Tapia, for your time.
Thank you.
And for your explanation here at CTD Studio.